manipulated or misused for nepotism or corruption or whatever. So then the issues come. So now is it the consequence of this bad nature? Then you go on, right? Anyway. So the fundamental rights was considered as absolute right and it's enforced. So the 1978 constitution, which enforced the fundamental rights and it's rights to the people, it's considered as absolute right. So this fundamental rights, when we talk about 19th Amendment, we can talk about this, how can we include this right to information. It's about fundamental rights. Anyway, that's, we can see. So some amendment, it happened, and someone will change. And then, if we continue this present constitution in a detail, but I don't go into that 172 articles which are talking about all the matters of the government, finance, defense, parliamentary, police council, language, all the states, nation, everything, fundamental rights and everything. But I do highlight some of the imperative articles which can be interest to discuss, and also it can be useful when we discuss about amendment and 19th amendment in short while. Right? So basically the article 1 to 8. So you can also have a look to when you download the constitution. It's available in online. So the states, Sri Lanka identifies independent free states. So that's necessity. So then the unitary states. So even though we have multiple nature in terms of language or people or religious, but still the unitary states. So sovereign states. So then it's very interesting to see the Article 3, the sovereignty of the people. I think the Sri Lanka is a very good example. The sovereignty is not the states, the sovereignty of the people is Sri Lanka. It's very interesting. Right? The people are the sovereign of this Sri Lanka, according to this constitution. Not the states, or not even the president, or not even the prime minister. Whenever people feel that man should be changed, change. So that's the beauty of this 1978 constitution, which we are practicing in our country. I mean, the sovereignty of the people is very imperative. So that's include the power of the government, executive, judiciary, and the legislative, and fundamental rights and fairness. And fairness means the right to vote, the elections, or the right to be elected. So the people's sovereignty is being practiced by three nature. I mean, the power of government included three categories: executive, legislative, and judiciary, and also fundamental rights and the friendship. Right? So it's very unique and very interesting to see. Power of the people. That's the sovereignty. So we may think the sovereignty of a nation, of course, sovereignty, when it comes to sovereignty, it's not necessarily only be limited to the people, of course, the territory and the states. There are three main categories: territory, people, and government. Are considered as a sovereignty of the particular states, identity or state bound. But in Sri Lanka, the people are given more priority and more bold fundamental nature into this category, right? And then you can see the Article 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 is about to identify the states. So this Article 1 to 8 gives an idea about states, about our nations. So people of this country are part of this nation. We are not likely or not. We are having one thing that. So that's why we identify ourselves. Or we respect ourselves, or we respect in terms of what. So that's, of course, based on constitutions, right? And then I say this Article 10 and 17, 10 to 17 is about more fundamental rights. When it comes to fundamental rights, it's all about rights, how to vote. I mean, we have votes and go to appeal. It's our fundamental rights. It's violent, we can go for appeal. But it cannot be compared to universal rights. Which can go anything, and it can be more applicable sometimes to Switzerland or Norway, which are identified as a developed